A big problem with innovation is asking people to have vision. Just show them. Southern Ontario has always had a large manufacturing base. If you look at Hamilton, Brantford, these types of places, they have had large manufacturing base and they haven't really won in a big way through globalization. Brantford's this place that got knocked down and the world doubts Brantford and it wants to get back up again and it's been helping us out. We have a volume aircraft, and as the size of the wing grows, you can lift a lot more and you can go a lot further. But we needed to get a parking spot for a much bigger wing. A big part of what we're doing right now is getting the right suppliers working with us so that we're not just trying to build something ourselves. We're going to the world leaders in different pieces of the puzzle, making sure we're working with them so the whole thing comes together in a much more robust way.
Legacy fabric structures are changing the way massive buildings are made in remote areas.
The next 6 months have a lot of certainty to them. Now we're measuring the laws of physics with computer models and they're matching. We're getting very confident that physically this thing is going to be a strong, reliable machine that will fly.
We also need to be able to build those wings, which means we need to have a fabric engineering shop. So we went to the UK and we hired the world's best fabric engineer, Steve Wallace.
Although it's not a lighter than air project, it uses a lot of lighter than air technology. And we're using state-of-the-art materials, which are laminated textile cloth, a really high strength, low weight fiber. As any aircraft, weight is always the enemy. So the lighter and the stronger that we can make it, the better the performance of the finished aircraft is. We're developing techniques to handle this cloth to build into the geometry of the wing. The excellence must be our lowest standard. The solar ship mission is a challenging mission. Lives will depend on it, both our air crew and also the customers that they're delivering products to.
Thinking about what solar ship is building, if you have one of the aircraft going to those remote areas, providing medical supplies, etc., it will actually impact not only for that community, but also for the society around them. It's an innovative idea, but also to say that it's Canadian made, it makes me also proud of being Canadian.
We're trying to build a system that is completely self-reliant, so we can put modern infrastructure into a place that has no infrastructure, and then you can connect that place to the world. It's not so much optimism, it's certainty. You start to get more sure that this thing's gonna work.